lack of a better word, is good. Read it right. Read works.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to episode 51 of Let's Play Wall Street Raider. I'm RakeM, your host. Last time out, we had a little bit of a downswing, lost about $3 trillion of our net worth, but it's not because of anything that we're doing. It's just that the subprime mortgage crisis is still wrapping up. We are seeing some progress, though, in that our GDP growth rate has gone from a negative 11% to negative 5.1. Our index is up about 800 points, and the prime rate is down. We got an easing policy an episode or two ago. It has now slipped to neutral, but it's remaining low, and more importantly is the short bond. I mentioned, I don't remember if it was last episode or the one before, that we really wanted this interest rate to be low when we came to January 1st so that we could buy and sell T-bills for a good profit. And let me show you what I'm talking about. We bought our bonds at a price of somewhere in the neighborhood of $83 to $85 a piece. And right now, because of this low rate, they are trading at $146.84. Now, if we hold on to them, we can make 2.24% of a, you know, yield on the bonds, or we can sell them for something like $60 a piece. In other words, a 60 to 70% markup, which is the equivalent of 35 years of income at this rate. Right? So let me show you the tax basis. So we spent just shy of $1.2 trillion, and they're worth $2 trillion. So I think that's right at 65%, somewhere in there. Right? So if we sell these off, we can make a bunch of money. Now, with the interest rate low and the GDP growth on the rise, the index is up. So I want to try to get some more index futures, especially since we just paid out the last of the money for the swaps that we had. So it's just a question of whether I want to sell off the bonds first or buy the index futures first. And I think what we want to do is we want to buy the bonds first, because that takes almost no time. Whereas selling these off, it's 5 transactions at a time, and then they make us go back to the menu to sell another 5 transactions. And we have, I think, somewhere in the neighborhood of $7 trillion in bonds. So it's going to take a while to sell them off. And having to come back to the menu every 5 transactions is going to mean that we're going to run some time off of the clock. So I think we want to get the index futures bought first. All right, so we'll come back to that in just a second. Anyway, we've got on our commodities, we've got gold everywhere. Got a couple that have wheat and a couple that have silver. We basically aren't making any money on gold yet. We have a buy price on wheat of $4. So it falls back down below four again, we'll buy some more. On corn, we're looking for 3.25. On crude, 65. So he's pretty much at his sale or buy price. We're just gonna wait and see what direction he goes in, and then silver, 13. All right, so the main focus today is gonna be to finish up the maintenance on all of our companies. We are in very good shape. We managed to get all these companies up into the high 30s to low 40s in terms of their market share. And we only have, I think it's 3 or 4 with 45% or more. And none of them is like, you know, this is the closest one, Toyota Europe, to 48%. But it's taken forever, but we have positioned ourselves very well. We have some maintenance items to do, but none of it's critical. So what we're going to do, I forgot about this. When we did our swaps at the end of the last one, all of these companies are now being governed by the autopilot. And so when we did these swaps, the autopilot went ahead and made them counterparties on the swaps. So we need to cancel all of these, but we've got until March to do it. So first things first is going to be buying the index, selling off the bonds, and then we'll start working these stocks, get the last of our maintenance items out of the way, do our last couple of rating parties, and We may even run the ticker next time, but I think it's going to take all of this one to get through all of these management tasks. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to go over to Fortis. We want him to be the one to buy the index futures. That way, his parent, Tokyo Marine, and RakeM Insurance will get to share in the profits from those. All right, so we're going to go buy as many index futures as we can get. Hopefully that'll be a bunch, and I'll be right back. Well, we got a bunch. We didn't get as many as I would like, but we did get something in the neighborhood of 1,300 or so. Let's see, where do they start? They start right about here, 12 of 2031. So maybe 1,500, somewhere in there. And we're already making money on it because it's rising. All right, oil is at its buy price. So let's go buy some oil before we start selling off bonds. Fast forward real quick while I do that, and I'll be right back. All right, so we got everybody invested in oil, and including PBR and Superior. And here's the earnings for RakeM Bank, or RakeM Insurance, excuse me, 9 cents, and he made 39 cents last year. So we want this to go up because we have options on him, or I have options on him. I've been losing money on it right now, or a lot of money on it. And it comes up in one quarter, right? Now I'm making money on this set because I got a much better price, but on this one up here, I got 1991. Now his net worth is higher than that, actually. Something like 22 almost. So if his projection is for more than 10 cents, hopefully we'll break even on those options. And it's 13 cents. So we need to go and sell off these bonds before this yield goes up any further, because it was 282 a minute ago and it's already jumped. So what we're going to do is we're going to sell these bonds. Now it's going to take time off the clock here while we do it. So we will interrupt to trade commodities. And if we get all the way to March, we'll interrupt in order to cancel all of these swaps. Although they don't start until the following quarter, so maybe we don't need to do that. So I guess we'll just interrupt if we get to June, which is not likely. All right, so everybody has bonds of some kind, by the way. Every insurance company and most of the banks. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna sell these off. And as long as the price is above 120, look at that, it's already down 9 points. But as long as this price is above 120, we're going to go ahead and do it. All right. As long as we can make a 50% profit on all of them, because that's equivalent to 25 years worth of bond income. And the interest rate is going to go up in that time, and we can buy these bonds back and make another profit. So anyway, I'm going to go ahead and fast forward. And like I said, I'll be back if we're going to trade some commodities. The price of silver has dipped below 13. So let's go to Berkshire and buy some. All right, and now it's jumped back up. So let's go back to selling bonds. And I'll be back if we trade some more commodities. We've sold off all of RakeM's bonds, all of Mitsui's bonds, and all of Tokyo Marine's bonds. We're now working on Progressive, but crude got up to 83 and now he's dropping. So we're going to go and sell all of our oil, and I would buy more gold, but we're all fully invested in it. So, and I think Phelps Dodge might have it sold short in his futures. So when we get done selling off our oil, we'll check on that. All right, so I'll fast forward and be right back. All right, we got all of the oil sold off, and now I'm going to try to buy some silver for Crown Books here. All right, now it's jumped up. So let's go back to selling off our bonds. We left off with Progressive, and we'll just keep an eye on these, and I'll be back if we need to trade some more. I like that our short bond yield keeps going down because our price is up to like 149 now. But with crude this low, we need to buy it again. So we're going to go buy oil, for oil for everybody. And I'll be back in just a minute. Everyone has oil once again, so we're going to go back to selling our bonds. I think we left off with INGG. Silver is getting down low again, so if it falls to below 1350, we'll buy some more of it. All right, interrupting once again to sell off silver now that it's above $16. So I'm going to start with me and start selling this off, and I'll be back in just a minute. Before we go back to selling bonds, I want to see if Phelps Dodge can either buy long futures of gold or short futures of silver. We weren't getting any counterparties when we tried to sell futures or buy futures of oil. I don't know that this is going to work, but let's find out. Okay, let's go back over to RakeM Bank and we'll resume selling off his bonds. I'll fast forward and be back if we're going to trade any more commodities. All right, here it is. Everybody cross your fingers. Our cheat scenario, our speculation in futures of T-bills is coming up. Hong Kong Shanghai Bank has an important development. Hong Kong Shanghai Bank operating profits to be buoyed by uncannily good timing on futures market trades. Inside sources in Wall Street have broken the news that major futures trading profits estimated at $495.8 billion will aid this quarter's earnings at Hong Kong Shanghai Bank. And that right there, ladies and gentlemen, is why you want to save up your karma. Because that is at least 10 times what any of the other cheat scenarios were worth that the game threw at us. The company's CEO apparently is taking full credit for this brilliant coup and is said to have strenuously denied insinuations that the excellent timing of the company's trades was based on any kind of inside information about the futures contracts in question. Allegedly, the bonanza was a result of careful research or good luck, not due to an insider tip-off prior to the highly favorable announcement that was made by the Federal Reserve Board just hours after the company acquired its massive positions in T-bills futures contracts. Cool. That is awesome news. So I guess everything here is out of range. So let's go back to the bank and we will resume selling our bonds. And kind of inexplicably, the index is headed down, but it shouldn't be, you'd think. But anyway, I'm going to fast forward while I sell some more bonds and I will be back when the conditions are right to do something else. We've sold off all of Rakeem's bonds, but now we have an antitrust suit here for Inditex. We had a total of 52%. I'm just going to say no. And that's that. Crude, we're going to buy here in just a minute, but we're still selling off all of the bonds at all the other banks. So we're going to pick up where I left off, and I'll be right back. All right, so now that we've sold all of our bonds off, let's go take care of all of our excess cash. So starting with the insurance companies, let's have Aetna. Let's see, can we get a bank for a good price? Is anybody underpriced? Let's see. Okay, well, here's one. SVB Financial. It's 100% public. Let's have Aetna buy him and give him some cash. All right, let's keep about $25 billion on hand and give him the rest. So let's give him $280 billion. And let's have him keep 10% on hand, so he'll need $30 billion. So we'll put $340 billion into mortgages. He is mediocre, so we'll increase our R&D. And it doesn't look like he has a swap to cancel. So we'll leave the dividend at zero for right now and we'll increase the R&D to 8%. Aetna out of the way, let's go to INGG. We have $1 trillion basically, minus this, so 840, 830. See, if we keep 10%, that'll be 50 billion. 50 billion? No, 500 billion. Okay, so 500 says, so 1 trillion minus 166, 834 will give to his bank. And here we want to have 200 billion. So we'll put 688 into mortgages. Silver's getting close. And spot wheat's pretty much ready to sell. He hasn't been up this high in a while. Let's come back to Progressive. Sell off Peak and Crown's wheat and my wheat. Alright, so Progressive, we want him to have 500 billion too, which gives us 944 minus this, so 812. And Nordbanken needs to keep 164 billion. Let's just put 700 into mortgages. TMFI doesn't have any excess cash. All right, so here, 500 billion's plenty. We'll give 1.4 trillion to his bank. Minus this, so 1.13. And here we want 100 billion, is that right? No, we want 1 trillion. So we'll put 215 and change into mortgages. Interest rates going up, which is affecting the gold price. It hasn't really affected silver yet. All right, so that was MMF. Let's go to RakeM Insurance. He's got 2 trillion minus this, so 1.76, let's say. Now, because we're doing so many trades in commodities, I want to have RakeM keep 20% on hand, which would be 5.2 trillion. So we can put the rest into mortgages, which would be about 8.9 trillion. Okay. All right, so let's see. We have sold off our wheat. So now all we have is gold and oil, and we'd like to get some more silver. So all of our little stuff is done. Let's go through every stock, top to bottom. We've got a little over half an hour to do that, and we'll see how far we can get. Hopefully we can get through them all. So let's start with SK Telecom. Here we're very capable, and the industry is improving. We're making 44 cents a quarter, right? So that's half our income. Oh, that's great. Nothing to do here. Let's go to PBR. Oh, well, let's make sure he doesn't have excess cash. Nope, no excess cash either. We got four stocks. He's good. He's good. And we just got a large government contract. Great. Finally, a bit of good news. Okay, so PBR. Let's pay off our loan. And we need to change banks too. Okay, we're invested in oil. Which is not ready to sell yet, but that's going up. So let's see. Our price is double. What's our target? 67? It's not too far away. Alright, so we're 27%. The industry is worsening, and we're very capable. Industry is worsening. Well, not by much. Sure would like to buy these guys. But it's really not possible. See, 28 plus this one, 29 plus this one would be 44. That would be 53, and then this one would be 58. So we can't buy it. Because IMO owns both Exxon and Mobil. All right, let's change our growth rate to negative 10. I don't know if that'll get us down that extra 4%, but maybe it will. All right, so he's done. Let's go to Twitter. We're very capable and the industry's improving, and we're making 33 cents a quarter. Growing negative, which is good. We can change this to 6. And the dividend to 52 cents. Okay, we can buy 19% of this one. Let's do that. Next up is Toyota. I think it's faster just to type them in there. So here, we're very capable. Industry's worsening. And we're not bringing any money in. What an idiot growing at 21%. Do we have him frozen? Yeah, where is he going to get the money to expand at that rate? He can't do that. Okay, so negative 10. We're very capable, so we'll make our R&D 6, and we'll kill the dividend. Now, we don't have any passive investments here, and we've got 40 billion. He's trading too high, too high, too high. Okay, they're all trading too high. So, he's done. Let's go to Kmart. We're reasonably competent. We're losing money. Industry's improving, though. Let's pay off our debt. Bring it negative 10, which is good. We're reasonably competent, so we're good on the R&D. Let's just kill the dividend. We've got no stock, but we also don't have any cash. So let's have his parent, Aetna, who has 30 billion, which is not enough either. I guess I didn't leave Aetna with enough cash. Right, Dayton Hudson is wholly owned. Costco we can buy a piece of. Aetna has enough to buy 19% of him. but he has 15 stocks. All right, let's give the cash then to him. And let's see if there's any others that we want to buy. Sam's maybe. Let's buy 19% of Sam's. Okay. Oil is ready to sell. So let's interrupt what we're doing and sell all of our oil. I'll do that and be back in just a minute. Finished Kmart, so let's move on to Red Hat. Here we are reasonably competent, spending 8%. We're bringing in money, and we got a 40% market share, and the industry is improving. Negative 10 is good, 8% is fine. So let's increase our dividend to 2%. So we'll make our dividend $2 and then we'll split him. All right, let's go to Rolls-Royce Aero. Silver is almost ready to buy. Oh, let's get rid of our oil on here. All right, where are we going? Next one is Rolls-Royce Aero. We're very capable, industry is improving, and we're bringing in money. Negative 10 is good. That's good too. And 7%. No, let's make it 9. And let's split him. NVIDIA is next. All right, we're very capable. Industry's worsening and we're not really bringing any money in. So negative 10, we can make this 6 and kill the dividend. And we might want to make a passive investment in HartMax, but we already have. So he's low enough, we could do him as well. And looks like we have a bankruptcy to deal with too. So let's buy 19% of Next Semiconductor, and then we'll figure out what to do with Hyundai Electric there. So 19% of him is gonna run about 32 billion. We've got that. All right, we managed to get it for 29. This one is wholly owned by the bank. And we don't really want him. Let's just get rid of him. Alright, oil is ready to buy again. So let's go through and buy all the oil we can. I'll be back in just a minute. Well, I got some, but the price shot up, so we'll hold off on the on everybody else. So, let's see. We left off with NVIDIA, and we're done with him, so let's go to IBM. Here we're losing a lot of money, but we're very capable and the industry's improving. We've got passive investments already. So let's kill our dividend. And we're very capable, so let's knock this down to 6%. All right, so Fuji Machine and Lenovo is who we have. And looks like we've picked up Great Wall. And we only have 37%. So let's buy him from the bank, liquidate him, and then pay off the debt. Okay. Crude's going down. We may be buying him in a minute. All right, so IBM's done. Let's go to Hewlett Packard. We're losing money here as well. We're reasonably competent and the industry's improving. So negative 10's good. Let's make our R&D 8% and kill the dividend. And we've got stock of Mitsubishi Electric, but that's all. Let's get 19% of these two as well. I think that's it for him. We've got 19% of all three of those. So that's it. All right, let's go to Juniper Networks, and on second thought, let's go back to buying oil. Before I buy it for PBR or Superior, I want to see if this will go back down again. But I've got it for all the holding companies. Silver is getting close. All right, so Juniper Networks is next. He's reasonably competent. Industry's improving, and we are making money. So negative 10's good. 8's good, and we can actually increase this. Let's make it 46 cents. We've got 15 billion. Let's pay off our debt. And let's see if there's anybody we can invest in passively. So the only one that's reasonably priced is RIM here, and he's in kind of in bad shape financially. Nortel here has swaps based on 500 billion. But he's in pretty good shape. It's just that he's trading too high. If he was at 140 or less, I'd take it. Qualcomm. All right, so he's losing a lot of money on something. So I guess we're finished with Juniper. Let's see, how's that going to affect him? All that negative. He might sell off some assets. He can't borrow any money. Oh, he can sell off stock though. He's got a lot of stock he can sell off. All right, so we're fine there. So he's done. Let's go to Fortis Securities. It did fall a little bit. Let's buy back these bonds. All right, so we are reasonably competent. Industry is improving and we are making money. So, yep, 12 is what we want. Negative 10 is what we want. And are we bringing in 22 cents? That's good enough. Let's make our dividend 24 cents. $13.28. That's good enough. Let's buy some silver and hopefully it'll go down rather than up so everybody can get it. I'll fast forward and be right back. The price shot back up, but I got some and Crown got some. Let's just check on the bank, make sure he's got enough cash. He does. And RakeM Insurance, his projection is still going up, but his stock price isn't moving. And it's going to have a devastating effect on my options here. That does not go up to meet his net worth. See what his net worth is now. Okay, so his net worth has dropped. You know what we need is we need a tightening policy. That's what we need. Wouldn't help us on our index futures, but it would help our stock prices. Every one of the insurance companies would rise in stock price if we had a tightening policy. All right, anyway, let's go over to Hoffman LaRoche. We're gonna do him real quick and then we'll go cancel these swaps. He's still making money. He's very capable and the industry is improving. Negative 10's good. Very capable, so 6%'s good. Let's make our dividend $1.20 and then split him. Alright, so we'll go cancel all these swaps at the bank and then we'll come back to Mitsui. Alright, so I'm going to fast forward while I cancel these swaps and I'll be right back. All right, so we got all the swaps canceled, but now oil is below his target price. So let's see if we can get some oil for PBR and Superior. Alright, so we got a little bit and all the physical we wanted. So let's go over to Mitsui. My notes say to invest passively in some of the other members of the industry here. We're very capable. Industry is improving and we are making money. So Texas Utilities here would be a good one. If he was making a positive return, we could do this one as well. Let's take a look at Excelion, or Exelon, excuse me. He's got cash. He's got options and futures. And he also has a swap. But he's making all kinds of money. He's worth $125 billion, so it'd be $25 billion to buy 19%. Let's get it. So our settings are fine. We just got to reform the industry. And that's well underway. Let's see if he has a swap. If he does, we'll leave him alone. But if he doesn't, okay, he does. So I guess he's done. Let's go to TBS. Let's buy some more silver. We'll come back to TBS. Alright, it's gotten up to 14, so we'll stop there. So we got, let's see, these four, and Berkshire, I think that's who all got it. Alright, back to TBS. We are reasonably competent, industry is improving, and we are losing money. Reasonably competent. With this much, we can make this 8% and kill the dividend. Turn around. Good. Let's pay off our debt here too. Let's see if there's anybody we can invest in passively. Yeah, if he had 20% invested in operating assets, we'd get him. Anybody else? NBC maybe? No? Nope, I guess that's it. That's all we're going to do. Alright, let's go over to Ford. Here we're very capable. Industry is improving. We have a tiny little income. Let's kill the dividend. And we're very capable, right? Okay. So we'll kill the dividend and we'll leave the R&D where it is for now. We got a lot of cash. We can either disperse it or passively invest. Can't invest in this one. And these credit ratings are too poor. So I guess what we'll do is we'll do an extraordinary dividend. So what we want here is 10 billion, no, 20 billion. So we'll disperse 21. All right, let's go to Korean. Here we got an income. It's down, but we got one. Very capable and improving. So let's see. Yeah, well, that's fine. We got a lot of cash. Can we passively invest here? No, they're all trading too high. So let's disperse 10 billion. All right, let's go to Lucky Gold Star. We're losing money here, but we're very capable and the industry is improving. So we'll make this 6% and we're losing money, so we'll kill the dividend. We got a lot of cash. Is there anybody we can invest in? Nope, they're all trading kind of high. So let's see, we need 14. We'll just disperse 3. And let's split him. Warner Lambert is next. Let's see, we're gold, nope. Silver, nope. Crude, nope. Okay. Warner Lambert. He's reasonably competent and the industry is improving. So we need to increase our R&D to 10%. And are we making money? Yes, we're making money, so we can leave the dividend at 22 cents. So let's increase this to 22 cents and the R&D to 10. All right, at United Continental, we're losing money and we're mediocre. And, 11% is fine, but let's kill the dividend. There's nobody worth investing in. So let's disperse 6 billion and kill the dividend. All right, so he's done. Let's go to Columbia Healthcare. And we don't have any dividend here. Let's see. We're reasonably competent. Industry is improving. And our earnings are on the way up, but we're not making that much. So let's leave the dividend where it is right now. We're mediocre, right? Let's back this off to 12%. Oh, we're reasonably competent. All right, let's make it 8%. We've got 4 billion in excess cash. Let's see if there's anybody we can invest in. Let's see how much of him is owned. All right, too much. And he's pretty small. So let's disperse 4 billion. Did we change his R&D to 8%? Yep. All right, let's go over to Diageo. We're losing money here as well. And we're very incompetent. So the R&D is fine. Let's kill the dividend. And we have some excess cash, but not very much. So that's all we'll do is just kill the dividend. All right, let's go to Comp de Rio. His income's way down, but he's very capable and the industry is improving. So this is good, and we just need to lower the dividend. Let's make it 16 cents. We don't have any excess cash. And we already have passive investments. We sold off Oregon Steel, so I guess that's it. Anybody have silver? Yeah, we got some silver. All right, silver is ready to sell. So I'm going to sell off my silver and I'll be back in just a minute. So while I was selling off silver, Toyota Europe was sued, and I just went through and told it no because he only had like 51%, and he lost the suit, and the damages was $12 billion. So yeah, that happened. Anyway, we did sell off our silver, and nothing else is ready to go, so we're getting kind of short on time, and we didn't get as far down this list as I'd hoped. We got down to Rio, and we're going to pick up where we, let's just do Mallinckrodt, and then we can pick up with Sciocorp next time. So we'll take care of Mallinckrodt, and then we'll move all of our excess cash over to the banks. So Mallinckrodt is very capable. Industry is improving and he is making a profit. So we can just lower this to 6% and I think we're done. We don't have any excess cash. So that's it for him. So let's go to Crown and all the holding companies and disperse their cash. For Crown and Peak, this time we're going to give it to their banks. So he's got $393 billion in excess cash. And we'll pay off the loan as well. And Peak has $442 billion. So I'm just going to fast forward while I donate all the, do extraordinary dividends for the excess cash. And then move it over to the banks, buy all the mortgages. Fast forward while I do all of that, and I will be right back. Looks like I moved too soon. Oil is ready to sell. So let's get rid of all of our oil and then we'll resume. The only two holding companies that I've done so far are Peak and Crown. So we'll just do the rest when we're done here. All right, so I'm going to fast forward while I sell off all of our oil and I'll be right back. So the only commodity we have left now is gold, well, in the index. All right, so let's go back to our insurance or our holding companies and we'll disperse all of our excess cash. I'll fast forward and I'll be right back. Okay, we've distributed all that cash. Now let's have the insurance companies give that cash to their banks. And now we'll have the banks buy mortgages. Okay, so it's March 31st and all the banks and everybody are going to declare, and my options are right about to expire, and finally his price is going up. So whether I'm going to make any money on this or not, I mean, I'm making 150 billion here, I'm losing 200 billion here. So the real question is whether or not this is going to go up and I'm going to make any money here. So what has to happen is he has to declare his earnings. They have to be up, and the projection for the next quarter has to be up also. And I won't make like double my money or anything, but hopefully I can break even between the two of those transactions. All right, so index is up, and we're making, I think we made a total of like $5 or $6 trillion on the commodities just this episode alone. Our net worth is up. And, you know, like I said before, we're poised very well. The GDP growth got all the way to a negative 1 point something, and now it's backtracked a little bit. But our prime rate is down again. Yeah, it's still on a neutral policy. So what we're going to be looking for is for that rate to change to tightening between now and June the 30th so that we don't lose money on these swaps again. Hopefully that'll happen, but, you know, we'll still make money if it does. If it doesn't. But we're out of time for today, so thank you for joining me. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please like and share. And until next time, this is RakeM saying, have a good one.